talk about the tackles and cover first correction on the sweep disadvantages in DLM. As an introduction, I first explain the characteristics of sweep architectures and the polysomnography findings. Thereafter, I will review some studies on treatment with cover lenses. Polysomnography, PSG, is carried out to investigate sleep architecture, sleep-related movement disorders, and sleep-disordered breath. This figure shows the scheme of sleep patterns in the elderly. There are some stages indicated in this scheme. Stage of wakefulness. Sleep stages, stage REM, rapid eye movement. And non-REM stages 1 to 4, shown in this here. As a consequence of an aging effect, alterations in sleep architecture are usually observed in the elderly. First, sleep latency time is prolonged, and the elderly complain of difficulties in falling asleep. Slow wave sleep, or deep non-REM sleep means stage 3 and stage 4 sleep. A sufficient amount of stage slow wave sleep is necessary for high quality sleep, but slow wave sleep usually decreases in the elderly, while the proportion of stage 1 sleep increases. The elderly complain of frequent arousals at night. The REM sleep time usually decreases. In addition to these factors, PLMS and sleep disordered breath, sleep apnea syndrome, induce sleep fragmentation and increase wake time after sleep onset. Then, what is PLMS? Periodic limb movement during sleep. PLMS characterized as repetitive movements of the lower extremities in sleep. In subjects over 50 years old, PLMS are often observed with polysomnography, rhythmic extensions of victor and dorsiflexions of the ankle are presented. Furthermore, PLMS are often followed by accelerated heart rates. As PLM increase, patients demonstrate frequent arousals at night. When the frequency of PLM exceeds 15 per hour of sleep time, the subjects meet criteria for PLM disorder. Because PLMS disappear after awakening, patients are usually unaware of PLMS. As I have stated, sleep disturbances are prevalent in the elderly, and the pathophysiologies are complicated. Next, I'd like to focus on the treatment of sleep disturbances. For successful treatment of sleep disturbances in the elderly, clinicians have to pay attention to certain issues. While benzodiazepines may be useful in younger patients, hangover effects are often present in the elderly. Amnesia or delirium are sometimes induced by benzodiazepines. In patients with sleep apnea syndrome, benzodiazepine was sleep apnea. Patients with ELM disorder are usually refractory to hypnotics. Therefore, an appropriate evaluation is necessary. Previous reports have demonstrated that clonazepam and dopaminergic agents are effective. After treatment with clonazepam or dopaminergic agents, the number of ELMs decreased and sleep disruption improved. Pharmacological investigations on therapeutical effects of herbal medicine for sleep disorders are not yet sufficient. But studies on TJ54 have been accumulated, so my presentation will focus on the effect of TJ54. Yokkan-san in Japanese. Here I'd like to abbreviate it as YKS. YKS was originally developed as a remedy for restlessness and agitation in children. In Japan, YKS has been approved for neurosis, neurotic disorders, insomnia, and nighttime crying in children. Recently, YKS is prescribed for psychiatric symptoms in dementia. This slide shows the ingredients of YKS. YKS is made from several herbs. The picture shows bright samples of each herb. Extract granules are administered. Detailed explanation of the procedure for producing YKS have been omitted here. We previously reported the effect of YKS on sleep disturbances in patients with dementia. Baseline polysomnography were carried out following the adaptation night. After baseline examinations, YKS was administered. After four weeks treatment, ESG was carried out again. ESG variables at baseline and baseline were compared with those after 4 weeks treatment. This figure shows ESG data of subjects at baseline and after YKS treatment. The length of each column indicates mean total sleep time. Sleep stages are expressed as stage 1 in orange, and stage 2 in blue, stage slow wave sleep in red, and stage REM in white. At baseline, a short total sleep time and increased percentage of time spent in stage 1 but not yet. After treated with YKS for 4 weeks, there was a significant increase in total sleep time and wake time after sleep onset were increased. There was also a significant increase in the percent of time spent in stage 2. The effect is reported to be associated with serotonergic action. This figure shows the number of awakenings analyzed by PSG. There was a significant decrease in the number of awakenings after YKS treatment. DRM index at baseline and that after treatment were compared. The PLM index was calculated as the number of PLM per hour of sleep time. There was a significant decrease in the PLM index after treatment. I consider that a decrease in the PLM index may be beneficial in decreasing the frequency of arousals at night. This slide shows a comparison of the Pittsburgh sleep quality index scores at baseline and after treatment. The Pittsburgh sleep quality index is one of the popular rating tools for evaluating subjective sleep quality. Lower scores mean higher sleep quality. There was a significant decrease in the Pittsburgh sleep quality index scores after treatment with YKS. Subjective evaluation as well as PSG data improved significantly. We also investigated the effect of YKS on insomnia in the elderly who had not significant cognitive impairments. The subjects were 10 patients with neurotic disorders. PSG variables after treatment were compared to those at baseline. This figure shows sleep architecture two periods. YKS treatment resulted in prolongation of total sleep time. Prolongation stage 2 and stage 3 and 4 and stage REM. Wake time after sleep onset shortened after treatment. As sleep disturbances increases and improves, daytime sleepiness decreases. In contrast to benzodiazepine, YKS does not affect sleep apnea index. YKS decreased the number of PLMS. YKS was effective in the elderly without dementias. Next, I'd like to review restless leg syndrome. To discriminate restless leg syndrome from other diseases exhibiting similar symptoms, it is necessary to diagnose by the International Criteria. This is composed of four essential criteria. Number one, an urge to move the legs, often accompanied with discomfort sensations. Number two, these symptoms begin or worsen during the periods of rest or inactivity, such as lying down or sitting. Number three, these sensations are partially or totally relieved by movement, such as walking or stretching. Number four, symptoms occur predominantly or exclusively in the evening or night rather than the day. Due to these symptoms emerging at bedtime, patients feel difficulties to fall asleep. Pathophysiology of restless leg syndrome, RLS, has been considered to be involved with a decreased function of dopamine system. Dopaminergic agents such as pramipexole are recommended as a first-line treatment for RLS. However, dopaminergic agents may induce adverse effects in the confrontation or warning divide. Therefore, these situations make it difficult to maintain remission for a long period. I previously reported with three patients with RLS. In these patients, pramlexol failed to improve RLS due to side effects. This figure shows the clinical course of RLS, RLS symptoms. The values represent the international RLS rating scale scores, and the severity of the symptoms. Severe RLS ranges from 21 to 30 points. Moderate RLS ranges from 11 to 20 points. Mild RLS ranges 10 points and under. These patients have been treated at another hospital. Pramlexol indeed reduced symptoms, but did not achieve full remissions due to side effects. After they visited to my department, my case was prescribed at evening and bedtime. As the symptoms improved and were well tolerated. All patients complained of sleep disturbances and daytime somnolence. YKS prescription appears to be beneficial for sleep state. After YKS prescription, mean total sleep time. Daytime sleepiness was evaluated with Epworth Sleepiness Scale Score, ESS. YKS improved daytime sleepiness in RLS. Next, I will discuss what properties are beneficial for sleep disturbances. In the interview, neuronal activities of dopamine and serotonin system are declined. Previous studies have investigated the effect of YKS on dopamine and serotonin in the aged rats. This study examined the effect of YKS on serotonin and dopamine system at the prefrontal cortex in the aged rats and young rats. In aged rats, basal serotonin and dopamine levels are decreased, as indicated in closed squares. Decreases in serotonin release and dopamine release were presented. The effect of YKS on serotonin, YKS administration indicated in open trials. YKS restored serotonin release and increased dopamine release. The effect of YKS on serotonin 2A receptor mediated behavior was investigated in mice. DOI is a serotonin 2A receptor agonist. Activation of serotonin 2A receptor results in increased number of head twitches in mice. Head twitches induced by DOI were inhibited by repeated administration of YKS. YKS was demonstrated to stabilize overactivation of serotonin 2 receptors. There are some studies investigating the effect of YDS on GABA system. Details will be completed. YDS appears to improve anxiety via GABA receptor. Taking these findings into consideration, I suggest the association between sleep disturbances and pharmacological properties of YKS. YKS may disturb the decreased function of dopamine system. Due to this action, PLMS may increase and decrease. Besides, YKS acts on GABA system and decreases PLMS and prolongs nocturnal sleep time. YKS may stabilize the altered function of serotonin system. It is beneficial to improve sleep quality. I consider that YKS may effectively improve sleep continuity due to these pharmacological properties. As shown previously, these are the ingredients of YKS. There are some limitations. Clinical studies are limited to open trials on case reports. Evidence on experimental data has been accumulated. However, not all the components have been sufficiently investigated. Further examination of each hub and the interactions among the ingredients are necessary. In summary, YKS is effective for sleep disturbance and is well tolerated. Neuroleptics may induce extraglandular signs. Benzodiazepines induce hangover effects. Patients rarely complain of adverse events when they are treated with herbal medicines. Thank you very much for your kind attention.
Okay, so any question? For the session. So, just a professional give us a very good talk. So that is a very traditional Chinese formula. YKS, yes. So, yes, YKS is very, so it's traditional Chinese formula, or just Japanese or Chinese, okay. Just the Oriental so medicine. So here I have one question. Why only use the age, the old people, but so cannot be used for the other age, the population?
Thank you.
Mm.
Herbal medicine is prescribed not only the elderly, but the range of I focus on the elderly because they are often present side effects. So careful attention is very necessary. So YKS is well tolerated and demonstrates fewer side effects. So especially in the elderly treatment in the elderly, our medicine is recommended.
Okay, any question? Yes, please.
Thank you, that was an interesting talk.
every single the action of every single hub is not sufficiently known. But the combination of these several hubs beneficial for.
Okay. But are there any interactions, that is adverse interactions between these seven, anything?
The data available for concerning YKS is limited to YKS, so individual data I have not.
But this is a traditional medicine which has been used for a long time or formulated by you?
Yes, for a long time. The same production is adapted.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Professor Shino. Yeah, I like your talk. My question is, your study showed this YKS formula has effect for the elderly, age-related insomnia. How about other insomnia like depression or anxiety-related insomnia? Do you have any study about that? Thank you.
Thank you. You refer to anxiety symptoms related to others. Anxiety in the patient with ALS. We also investigate the effect of anxiety. The sustained symptoms of ALS induces, often induces ALS. So after treated with YKS for 4 weeks, some data on Hamilton anxiety scale was decreased. It also appears effective in anxiety symptoms. And so on.
Yes, please.
This is Professor Akram from Saudi Arabia, pharmacology. We know benzodiazepines like diazepam, they also activate GABA. They are called GABA mimetic. Also, we know that dopamine activation is related to dependence. And we know benzodiazepines cause dependence. When these ingredients of YKS also activate GABA, also activate dopamine, is there possibility of dependence on this drug? Is there any study conducted in this regard, please?
Thank you. It also an important issue. The previous data indicates YKS does not activate dopamine or GABA, but stabilize the neuronal function. So decline of dopamine is a little but gradually restored, but over-activation is not occurred. The same finding demonstrated benzodiazepine and 5-HT. So over-activation does not occur. So addiction or abuse are rarely observed in the patients.
Thanks
so much.
Okay, thank you.